click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see the operation of a single phase inverter, of which the configuration we have studied in the previous video. Where you can see the thyristor and diodes are connected in a 90 parallel way. Now we are going to see how they are going to work. So I have divided the operation of the single phase inverter into two different modes. So first I have mode T0 to T1. Now this naming convention you can understand if you look at the diagram. These are the voltage and current waveforms for a bridge inverter. So these waveforms which we are going to study in the next video, but I'm just showing you from where I have taken this T1 to T2 and all that. So my first mode will start from 0 to T1 and then my second mode will start from T1 to T2. You just remember that from 0 to T1 that I have considered as a mode 1. So in mode 1, if you see carefully, this waveform shows that IG1 and IG2. That means IG1 stands for the gate current for SCR1 and IG2 stands for gate current for SCR2. Correct? The second waveform you can see. So you will see the pulses from T1 to T2. So this particular waveform stands for IG3 and IG4, where IG3 is nothing but gate current given to thyristor 3 and IG4 is a gate current given to thyristor 4. You just remember this, that from 0 to T1 I am having IG1 and IG2 on, and from T1 to T2 I am having IG3 and IG4 on. Now depending on that we will see the operation. So this is my configuration, correct? So if you see the first, that is from T0 to T1, if you consider this as a mode 1. Now in this mode 1, IG1 was given and IG2 was given, correct? So that means SCR1 is on and SCR2 is on. Now this is the positive terminal of a DC voltage and this is the negative terminal of the DC voltage, correct? Now if my SCR1 is conducting, it will act as a closed switch, correct? Because we have studied that at a time we are firing only two SCRs, so that two SCR will work and two SCR will be in an off state. So if I'm giving only IG1 and IG2, whereas IG3 and IG4 is zero, if you noticed this waveform, you can see IG3 and IG4 is 0 for time instant 0 to T1, but IG1 and IG2, there were pulses from 0 to T1. So that means only SCR1 is on and SCR2 is on. So positive will get connected to A point of the load. Now here I am assuming load is only resistive load. We are looking at the operation by using the resistive load. Remember this, the load is a resistive. And negative will get connected to B terminal. So if these two SCRs are working, what will happen? They will act as a closed switch. So my current will start flowing through this plus point from here, from SCR1 at point A through load, then point B, then through SCR2, and then from here at the negative point. This is how my current will flow. Now if you look at the diagram, this is my mode 1 from T0 to T1. So SCR1 will be act as a closed switch and SCR2 will be act as a closed switch. So my current will start flowing in this way from positive voltage V till point A, from resistive load R, from SCR2, and then at this point. So my current will be IL is equal to V by R and my voltage will be positive and negative. So this is nothing but the voltage which is appearing across the resistive load. Now if I draw the diagram, what I'm getting the output. I'll simply draw like this. So from 0 to T1, I'm getting the positive voltage V, correct? Because here S1 and S2 is on, or you can say conducting. This both S1 and S2 are on. I'll just show you the waveform. See, you can see here IG1 and IG2 is given the gate current. They are getting the firing angle. So SCR1 will be on, S1 and S2 are on. So there will be flow of a current. So you'll get the output voltage across the resistance. And obviously, if there is a voltage, there will be flow of a current, and that is equal to voltage across the resistance divided by the resistance value. This is what happening in a T0 to T1. Now, when we reach at the T1, we need to know that I need to have some commutation circuit. That means SCR1 and SCR2 should be forcefully commutated, because here we are not using AC voltage, we are using a DC voltage. Since we are using DC voltage, we have to commutate thyristor by using the external commutation circuit. So when you want to fire SCR3 and SCR4, at the same time your SCR1 and SCR2 should be turned off by using the commutation circuit. Now my next mode is from T1 to T2. Now from T1 to T2, if you memorize the voltage and current waveforms from T1 to T2, SCR3 and SCR4 were given the gate current. So let's see in this diagram first. So look at this diagram. Now the SCR3 is on, turn on, gate current is given for the SCR3 and gate current is given for SCR4 as well. So this will also be turned on and this will be open circuited. Correct? Now if this is the case, what will happen? This positive terminal of a DC will get connected to first point B. Correct? And this negative will get connected to point A. So here in this case, what will happen? My DC voltage, my current will start flowing from this point to first SCR3 because it is conducting, then from point B to load, then from A, and then S4 is conducting. So in this way, my current will flow. So if you look at the diagram for mode 2, see here the positive will get connected to point B. This is my point B and this is my point A. So this will be positive and negative. So my voltage will be minus V and current will be IL is equal to minus V by R. Correct? So you can see SCR3 will act as a closed switch. My current will flow in this way. SCR3 from point B, resistive load R, then point A, then SCR4, and this way. So my current will be minus VR. Now why my current is minus VR? Basically this positive and negative, whether you will get positive voltage or negative voltage, this you will understand in a voltage and current waveforms that we are going to see in the next video. But before that, I want to make sure that you have understood the concept, what will happen. So here there is no positive and negative half cycle. Here we are not getting the output because of the positive and negative half cycle, but here we are getting the output because we are purposely switching on some thyristor at point and we are purposely switching off some thyristor at the different time. So from T0, if you see from T0 to T1, I am turning on my SCR1 and 2. So SCR1 and SCR2 will conduct simultaneously, which will give me the positive voltage and positive current. In next part, that is from T1 to T2, SCR3 and SCR4 will get a firing so that they will turn on. At the same time, my SCR1 and 2 should be turned off. Now, this is a one particular cycle. Now, for the next cycle, what have to be done? SCR3 and 4 should be commutated. They should be turned off before my SCR1 and 2 should be turned on. That is how I'll get the AC input one by one for each cycle. I hope you have understood the operation of the single phase bridge converter. So in the next video, we can see the different types of waveforms we'll get at the output side. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Do subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you so much.